You can inquire about becoming a member by going to our website and clicking on the link. So that's sanctuary.org. Or you can email Athena at info@sanctuary.org. So please do consider donating to Sanctuary. We are donation run. All donations currently go towards helping us with legal costs, basic operations, and hopefully soon finding a location for in-person services. So we do have a great vision here at Sanctuary, which includes a community built on sustainability through permaculture and more opportunities for services with our sacrament for members. We welcome cash as well as in-kind donations. So for cash donations, you can see the link, which Athena will be dropping in the chat if she hasn't already. And for in-kind donations, just reach out to us and let's talk about that via email or phone. So these Sunday services are a place we gather together as a currently small but growing community. Although we don't partake in the sacrament during these services, we find common ground together in our recognition that mushrooms have brought us together. So for more information on sacrament services with the sacrament, do reach out to us via email and we can talk about what we currently have to offer there. So this service portion of our gathering, which we'll be starting here in a minute, it's around 30 minutes of silent participation on your part. Athena and I will be facilitating the service today, and Eric will be leading an optional discussion afterwards, which we'll allot 1 hour for, so until 11:30. So we do invite you to participate in that if you feel called, no pressure if you're not up for it today or have other places to be. And we wanna give you a heads up that in the near future, the discussion portion after the service will be for members only. Right now we're opening it up to everyone as we're still very small and growing. But yes, we'll announce this in advance when it's members only. We do consider the space to be very private and sacred. So we'll have two readings this service, and every Sunday we'll be moving through different texts throughout our time together. Right now we're reading from the Tao Te Ching and also the Science of Being Great. We chose these readings because we feel that they communicate the messages we've often received from our time spent with the mushroom, but in different ways, kind of in different languages, so to speak. So we'll also read from a poem, which is read to acknowledge our oneness with all that is. So right now I'm gonna pass it on to Athena. She's going to begin the service. Please do get as comfortable as you can. And thanks again for joining us. We hope you do stay for discussion afterwards if you're able, and if not, we wish you a great Sunday and holiday and week ahead.
Thank you, Courtney. Again, welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us today. I see a lot of new faces, so thank you so much. We are so happy and grateful to be gathered together today to expand our experience of the collective consciousness. And we recognize our oneness with each other in nature, striving to become more aware of this in our everyday lives. And with those words in mind, I invite you to get comfortable, take a moment to do a body check, and we'll do a 5-minute meditation together, really setting those intentions for today, recognizing why we've come together today, and sending that energy out. So I invite you to close your eyes or find a nice spot to look at and take a deep breath and exhale. Take a deep breath.
Okay. Give you a moment to come back, open your eyes, and join me for this reading from the Tao Te Ching. This is chapter 10. In keeping the spirit and the vital soul together, are you able to maintain their perfect harmony? In gathering your vital energies to attain suppleness, have you reached the state of a newborn babe? In washing and clearing your inner vision, have you purified it of all dross? In loving your people and governing your state, are you able to dispense with cleverness? In the opening and shutting of heaven's gate, are you able to play the feminine part? Enlightened and seeing far into all directions, can you at the same time remain detached and non-active? Rear you people, feed your people, rear them without claiming them for your own. Do your work without setting any store by it. Be a leader, not a butcher. This is called hidden virtue. This is the poem that we read every Sunday, a litany of gratitude. I invite you to join me when I say we live in all things live in us. We live by the sun, we feel by the moon, we move by the stars. We live in all things live in us. We eat from the earth, we drink from the rain. We breathe of the air. We live in all things. All things live in us. We call to each other. We listen to each other. Our hearts deepen with love and compassion. We live in all things. All things live in us. We depend on the trees and animals. We depend on the earth. Our minds open with wisdom and insight. We live in all things. All things live in us. We dedicate our practice to others. We include all forms of life. We celebrate the joy of living and dying. We live in all things. All things live in us. We are full of life. We are full of death. We are grateful for all beings and companions. Thank you.
I will lead us in our chapter today, chapter 10 of The Science of Being Great. You are a thinking center in original substance, and the thoughts of original substance have creative power. Whatever is formed in its thought and held as a thought form, must come into existence as a visible and so-called material form. And a thought form held in thinking substance is a reality. It is a real thing, whether it has yet become visible to mortal eye or not. This is a fact that you should impress upon your understanding, that a thought held in thinking substance is a real thing, a form, and has actual existence, although it is not visible to you. You internally take from the form in which you think of yourself, and you surround yourself with the invisible forms of those things with which you associate in your thoughts. If you desire a thing, picture it clearly and hold the picture steadily in mind until it becomes a definite thought form. And if your practices are not such as to separate you from God, the thing you want will come to you in material form. It must do so in obedience to the law by which the universe was created. Make no thought form of yourself in connection with disease or sickness, but form a conception of health. Make a thought form of yourself as strong and hearty and perfectly well. Impress this thought form on creative intelligence. And if your practices are not in violation of the laws by which the physical body is built, your thought form will become manifest in your flesh. This also is certain. It comes by obedience to law. Make a thought form of yourself as you desire to be, and set your idea as near to perfection as your imagination is capable of forming the conception. Let me illustrate. If a young law student wishes to become great, let them picture themselves while attending to the viewpoint, consecration, and identification as previously directed, as a great lawyer, pleading their case with matchless eloquence and power before the judge and jury, as having an unlimited command of truth, of knowledge, and of wisdom. Let them picture themselves as the great lawyer in every possible situation and contingency. While they are still only the student in all circumstances, let them never forget or fail to be the great lawyer in their thought form of themselves. As the thought form grows more definite and habitual in their mind, the creative energies, both within and without, are set at work, and they begin to manifest the form from within, and all the essentials without, which go into the picture, begin to be impelled toward them. They make themselves into the image of God, into the image, and God works with them. Nothing can prevent them from becoming what they wish to be. In the same general way, the musical student pictures themselves as performing perfect harmonies and as delighting vast audiences. The actor forms the highest conception they are capable of in regard to their art and applies this conception to themselves. The farmer and the mechanic do exactly the same thing. Fix upon your idea of what you wish to make of yourself. Consider well and be sure that you make the right choice, that is the one that will be the most satisfactory to you in a general way. Do not pay too much attention to the advice or suggestions of those around you. Do not believe that anyone can know better than yourself what is right for you. Listen to what others have to say, but always from your own conclusions. Do not let other people decide what you are to be. Be what you feel that you want to be. Do not be misled by a false notion of obligation or duty. You can owe no possible obligation or duty to others that should prevent you from making the most of yourself. Be true to yourself, and you cannot then be false to any person. When you have fully decided what thing you want to be, form the highest conception of that thing that you are capable of imagining, and make that conception a thought form. Hold that thought form as a fact, as the real truth about yourself, and believe in it. Close your ears to all adverse suggestions. Never mind if people call you a fool and a dreamer. Dream on. Remember that Bonaparte, the half-starved lieutenant, always saw himself as the general of armies and the master of France, and he became in outward realization what he held himself to be in mind. So likewise will you. Attend carefully to all that has been said in the preceding chapters and act as directed in the following ones, and you will become what you want to be. So I invite you now to bring your journals out if you have one near you. And we will again take 5 minutes to reflect on these readings and a couple questions we have to offer. Is in what ways can these readings be viewed for the lens of the sacred mushroom? And I'll repeat that one. In what ways can these readings be viewed through the lens of the sacred mushroom? And our second offering, how can these readings be applied to everyday life and or personal growth? So how can these readings be applied to everyday life and or personal growth? So I'll set for 5 minutes and we'll take the time to reflect on these passages today.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you all for taking that time. So with that, concludes our service, and we'd like to, I'd like to recognize for us that we've come together with intentions of service to the land and all its inhabitants. It is in our hearts to go forth into the world with the collective consciousness. We encourage everyone to stay for continued fellowship and conversation around our readings today. And for those unable to stay, we thank you again for being with us. And I will end the recording at this time.